Hello, everybody. Welcome back to City Skylines with me, Biffa, here in the city of Teaport. And today we are going to be working on our campus area. Let's zoom out a little bit. So I've always sort of earmarked this for our campus, even though I've sort of put industry and things around here, because I knew at some point I'd be sort of changing what was going on. If you have been following this series from the beginning, we unlocked this square in here. This was our first area. Lots of people always complain about the dirt roads here. The people that live here love the dirt roads. They really do enjoy them, so they're going to stay. So this has become less and less industry. And the last few little bits to go, if we just zoom in down here, here we go. We've got these water treatment plants, the inland water treatment plants. So I'm not putting any sewerage anywhere outside. These need to be moved and upgraded. We've also got the geothermal power plant, so that needs to move. Oh yeah, the Hugo there, school for kids that can't traffic good. That'll stay. And then that opens up this whole area for campus. We've got the trees. It got access here to our monorail. We could even have access to our tram that comes up there. Access to all these houses. We've got this metro that can come in. Suddenly we've got all these options. So where are we going to put our water treatment facilities and all of that? Well, we've got a couple of spots over here. This is all industry. These are all factories. I think this little spot here would be quite good. It's surrounded by offices, so that's not going to give us too much of an issue with noise and all that sort of thing. And there we go. After a little bit of furtling around, we've got these lined up. We've got plenty of coverage now, room for growth, and we could always put a couple more on the end there as well. I was just thinking, is there any other items in here that we could perhaps add? There we go. Lots and lots of water availability coming through that, which means... Oh, let's delete these things over here now that we don't need these anymore. And then over here... Cool, beans. That's okay. Right, I'm going to remove these as well. There we go. Our people have got their lovely piece of coastline back again, which is fantastic. Let's just remove these unneeded water pipes. Oh, I do like tidying things up. Ah, there we go. And they're all going to complain about the flooding. Yeah, let's just help them out with that. Oh, my goodness me. Let's just pause before this whole thing floods. Let's smooth out the land like this. So brush size a bit bigger. That water then is going to run on past. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Yeah, there we go. Look, it's not going to come up anymore. And this will get sucked up by the people that come along in the trucks and suck up all the water that's now flooding everybody away. Sorry. Just think of it as your car, your road, your yard, your garden, your pool out the back, your tram being nice and cleaned and washed. Where's it all running to now? It's all running back again. It all runs to the lowest point, and then we've got to hope that the vacuum trucks come along. Yeah, we'll be fine. Good. So now we've got this front back along here. Why is that doing that when all I did was remove a thing from over here? What the heck? What the heck? Oh, what the heck? Is that all I did was remove some water things off the side and it's like disrupted all the water. I suppose the water's not being sucked up by the things anymore. Oh, I'm so sorry. People, what is this building here? Organic dry goods. Yeah, not so dry anymore, are they? I'm sorry. That you should update your business name to, yeah, there we go. Organic wet goods. I'm just going to hope that that sorts itself out. We could carry this key wall along here now, couldn't we? To sort of finish this edge a lot, finish this edge off. Do you know what? I think I might just do that. Well, we've got the key wall in. The water has taken a long time to disappear. I'm not entirely sure whether we do have any pumping services. I think that's okay. Driving up alongside the building there. Yep, very good. And then we'll attach this, and then hopefully we'll straight away see some trucks go out. Happy to suck up all of that water. And there they go. There they go. There we go. He just sucked up all of that water there and then just disappeared. I don't know where he's gone. Very weird. Very weird. But I think that's probably... Oh, they're miles away. They're not even in the place that I was expecting them to be. That must have been flooding as well. Good grief. Well, let's have a look down here. There they are. Look. Sucking up all the water. That's what we want to see. Yes. Thank you, vacuum trucks. You've saved our day. Yep, for some reason this water's like running in underneath there. I don't know where that is going. That is just weird. As long as it's not popping out somewhere else. But everyone's moving back in. We are fine. Good, good, good. Okay, there we go. So there's our geothermal power plant set up. I quite like this with the little car park and the train that runs through the back as well. I think that looks very cool. Very cool. I like that. Okay, so that's our power and our water systems moved. What else do we have? Let's zippity-doo-dah around here that we need to shift out the way. I need to delete those fences. And then I think we're almost done. Post-sorting office. Fire helicopter depot, firehouse, the school's going to stay there, waste transfer. So let me just get those moved around. Okay, fantastic. We have this area clear. Now, we've got these little ruins here, which I'd like to make sort of a feature of. What are they? Oh, they're like burnt out houses. Oh, I thought they were like rocks and ruins and things. Do I want to make a feature of these inside inside the university? We need to have a name. We need to sort of have a little story with these. That these were, this was the original school that was built many, many years ago. And there was a tragic accident, and unfortunately the whole place burnt down. But for posterity's sake, it's been kept. So, yeah, we need to maybe have a little name for that, and we'll make a little feature of that. But this road sort of layout here and the rail layout, I'm going to just change this around a little bit just so we've got a little bit more room over here. Right, so this is the area that we've got to work with. And like I said, we've got monorail coming up from down here. We've got tram access here. Train access if we want it here. We could even bring this over to this section like that. And that would give us access to this metro that's over here. And yeah, that's fantastic. So many options to bring people in from various points around our city, and as it gets even bigger as well. I just did a very quick poll on Twitter to see which of the three options that we have here, the trade school, the liberal arts college, or the university campus, that people like. And the outright winner, with so many more percentages than the others, let me just flick over to that and tell you. With 60% of the vote was the university. Trade school and liberal arts got 20% each. So yeah, we are going to go with the university, which is this one here. So I'm thinking our entrance is going to be over here. We have our bus and monorail hub right there. So I don't think we need this other extra monorail that's coming down here. So we're just going to get rid of that, which is fine. And then we're going to run a row just up here that we can put our administration building off of. Let's just go for a very nice looking tree-lined road. What else have we got? Yeah, let's go for this one here with the trees up in the middle. I think that looked very nice. We could run that off of here like so. Let's go up like that. I'm going to go along that way. I'm going to go along this way. And then I want some sort of... I do want a car park in here as well. So we need to sort of think of that. How big is this building? So this is the administration building, which is going to set this area up. Bish. There we go. So this is our campus area. We need a good name for this campus area. So you need to let me know of a cool name that we can use. As always, T-related, roundabout-related, anything that's sort of to do with what we do in our series, let me know. Oh, and that just fits in so well there, doesn't it? Look at that. That just fits in so well. I love the style of this building. Very nice, very nice. Lots of paths coming off of that as well, so we can start spreading out around the rest of our area. So we can definitely connect up to this path that's going through here. So let's do that. Let's take this one here. That can just go straight across. Very good. So let's just move that up a touch. There we go. So that's nice and straight. And I'm thinking we could have a little car park just sort of over here on the side. Yeah, let's add that in. And for those that I always get questions asking what these are, they're just called parking lots. If you search on the workshop for parking lots, scroll up and down, you will see these on there. Okay, there we go. So we've got our main admin building. We have our little car park here, which will be good. And then what other options do we have? So we have our university dormitories, which gives us extra student capacity, as you can see on the bottom right of that pop-up. We have our study hall, which again gives us extra student capacity. We have a university groundskeeping, which just basically tidies things up, increases attractiveness and land value of the campus area, and then the futsal club. So I'm just thinking that we could pop a couple of these. I would like this area here to be where all the students stay. So I'm just going to grab this path here. And we're just going to wiggle this around. I might end up... Is this a different path? I think it is. Oh, no. I've already used the campus path in here. Fantastic. I'll come back and I'll move these little other things around. So we want to... Let's just see. I'd like around here. Let's just go like this. I want... Oh, helicopter's going over. I want this to be some sort of focal point... All right, we're going to do that. Fair enough. Let's just grab the move it mod. Shiftify this around a little bit. There we go. So I want this to be a focal point. These burnt down old houses, they're the history. They're the history of Teaport. The original settlement school was here. And yeah, the story I said before. So that's what we're going to do. And then I'm going to have this running along here. Let's go like that. No, that's too close again. Let's just go like this. Yeah, that's going to go around. That's sort of going to finish over there somewhere. So if I popped a couple of dormitories looking into this, so we could have one there, and then we can add some more as we go along. I'm going to put trees along the back to protect sound-wise. So let's grab our Move It mod, this tool here, double-click on trees, and this sort of shape. You probably can't hear that. There's lots of houses upgrading now. I've been putting these down. Look over there. Which is nice. That's what we want to see. Let's make sure that, before we do this, make sure this one is on collision. Otherwise, we don't want to mess around and start putting trees over the top of our railway line. Okay, so let's copy those. I'm going to sort of go like this. Don't want too many out the back. We still want a bit of space in case we want to add any other things. Oh, all the upgrades going. I love it. And we'll put that the other way around like this as well. We'll get some on the other side. Just to sort of keep the noise of the railway line. It's not that busy. It's not too many people going up and down it. There we go. That's good. I like that. Plus, they're looking over the lake as well, which is really nice. Excellent. Okay, so that's increased our capacity already. Let's see what we're up to. Let's click on this one here. So, the academic year is in full swing. Our reputation is already level one. We need to get 500 students, 2 academic works, and our campus attractiveness up to 200 to get to the next level. So, at the moment, our attractiveness is 50, tuition fee 675, expenses 864. So, you know, we're going to be spending a lot of money, but look, we've got 11 million simoleons, tea leaves, whatever you want to call them. And quite often, my weekly income is up above 50,000. So I'm really not too worried. We do have another university in the city, which I'll be shutting down as well. So we will get to that. Let's just add this path coming up here. So this one here is going to go straight out. So we're going to have off of here our study hall on one side. Let's have that right up against the road like that. And then on the other side, we've got a university groundskeeper. I think that, let's have a look. That can sort of be right by the car park over there. And then we've got our futsal, our sporty little thing. That can be over here. So let's just run in amongst the trees, a nice little straight path. And that can be off there. Look at that. Fantastic. Oh, you can hear them inside already. Can we have a look in the window? Let's zoom in. Anybody inside? Oh, we can't see. But they sound like they're having a fantastic game in there. Cool. Great. So we want to encourage everybody to come over here. Let's start giving them plenty of ways to get in. So we've got our tram up here, which does a turnaround. What routes do we have coming along there? Let's just quickly check that. None. Oh, none of our tram routes use that anymore. Oh, that's interesting. Well, this one here could definitely be added to come up here, couldn't it? So if we grab this. Yeah, how am I going to do this? Do you know what the easiest thing would be to do is just to add a walking path from there to here. So I'm actually going to use the university one with the trees. Excuse the burping frog in the background. Have you heard that? I'm going to run that down to there like so. I'm going to just connect this one up a little bit closer. There we go. And that one a little bit closer to there. And then if we grab our tram stop, this one here that comes up, I'm going to add a stop in right near there. Now, where does that one go? That comes in all the way along here. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. So it's picking up people from all of this area, which is a hugely populated area. So as well as walking over, getting the monorail, they can also get that. We've got a little path coming out here, which goes across. Let's just make it a little bit easier. We're going to add a path over here. Let's turn off road guidelines. That's it. Thank you. So we'll add that across there. I'm just going to, let's just move that over, get it a little bit closer. Nice. So they can get in there, which is cool. What about over here? Could we add, so this path comes down here. This actually connects to all of this, does it? They're walking across. Yeah. So we've got path connection down here if they wish to walk in. We've got path connection over here if they wish to walk in, which is nice. Over this side. Yeah, this is like a sporty sort of area that we've got over here. So we do need some sort of access from this side to this side. And we're going to upgrade some of these roads as well. Let's just change these. So this is going to be, let's have a look, this one here. Let's upgrade that. And this one here. Nicer roads, very good. We've got this path that comes along here and stops dead now. So could we connect that? I think that would be a nice idea. So let's bring this one straight out to there. Will it go underground? I don't think this one does. Okay, well, that's fine. Let us grab this path. So we'll transition. There we go, underground. We're going to go under there, across there, and then we're going to come back up again and join onto that. Aha! And then this one here, I can delete that. Thank you very much. I'm not sure which one that is, so I'm going to use the picker mods. And then we're going to just connect this back up again. It was connected to a road that was here, but the road has since been moved. There we go. So we now have access to our walk-in network, which goes all the way through up here. And they can walk down this way, get into the university campus, which is fantastic. How are the people doing coming in? Oh, look at that. Attractiveness, 175. We are so close. Well, there's one more thing that we can add, which I believe will give us some extra attractiveness, is the aquatic center. I'm not entirely sure whether that does. We've got the basketball arena, aquatic center, track and field, baseball park, and American football stadium. Let's just go for one of the smaller ones for now. The aquatic center, right. Oh my goodness me, that is huge. Wow, I need a sip of tea for that one. That is much bigger than I thought it was going to be. Yeah, let's just have a quick pause the game. Let's just have a quick path redistribution. Let's remove that. Let's go to... So which one should we put in? We've got the aquatic center. I think the aquatic center is nice. Or the basketball arena. What with that and the football and everything, I think the basketball arena would be perfect. It just means we need to sort our tram out. Okay, let's just delete that. Will that fit in? Oh, look at that. That just fits in nicely with our tram going past. Ooh, mama. And then we just need to sort out our little path over here. So let's do that. Let's grab our path. So this one here is going to start there, go out, and it's going to go underground. There we go. Then it's going to connect to this one. Let's just delete that little bit there. Let's just put a little curve on that. Nice. Excellent. So they can get in and out, get across here. They can join. Oh, we've got this path network up here. Let's just help these guys and girls. Go this way and connect. So if we go down to ground level, I think that's it. We'll come across there. Connect up to there. That looks good to me. Excellent. Excellent. Now, did that actually increase the attractiveness? It did. Lots of expenses, but yes. So now it's just waiting for the students. What I would like to check is where my other university is. So we've got this one here, which I believe is all the way over here. Is that it? Yeah. So how close is that? So they can get over here. Do we have another one down here somewhere? Yeah. Whoop, jumpy game. We've got this one here as well. That one I would keep. So how many students are in that one? 1,460. But this one here isn't too far away, and they can get there. Is this one down here as well? Oh, look, another one down here. Right. Shutting you down. Everyone's going to complain. And where was the other one? Over here somewhere. There it is. I'm going to shut you down. So that should be an extra couple of thousand students that find their way over to this campus area. We'll keep an eye on that. So we need to make it easy for anybody walking from over here to get over this way. Let's have a look. So this path's connected up. What I would like to do is we've got this metro over here. If we could just run a path from there across the other side as well. There we go. So we've now got walking access from where our metro is over here. So any that are coming into that. And also from the tram. Let's just check. There is a tram stop over here. Got those two tram stops there. Yeah, I think that's fine. They will walk from there, get on the path. Let's just connect this path up. Make sure 110% that this is going to work. Sorry, houses that are there. Nope, don't want that. I want you above the ground. Connect to that for me. Yep, there we go. So they can now walk across there, get on there, come out the metro, get on there, come across, walk into this. Yeah, I think that is pretty good access for everybody everywhere, coming in from every direction. So now it's just hoping that all of our students are going to move over here. And then we need to try and get some academic work. So let's just have a quick look at our policies. So student healthcare... student provided free healthcare, campus... Yeah, we can afford that. We're going to do that. Free lunch. Increases student happiness. We're going to do that. Visiting scholars affects all faculties within the campus area. Faculty bonus plus 25%. Upkeep by 25%. We're going to do that. Universal education. Students don't pay any tuition fees. I don't think I'm going to do that yet. No income. What is the income that we're getting? Oh, I didn't need to click that, did I? 1,000. We're not actually getting that much income. Do you know what? We're making so much money. Universal education for everybody. Why the heck not? Fan club supports. Increases the odds of winning home and away matches. Cost 180 a week. Arena. Yes, we're going to have that. Advertising campaign. Amount of visitors by 20%. 200 a week. Yep, we're going to do that. Sponsorship deals. Reach acclaimed campus. We can't do that one yet. Academic works. Ching. We're going to do all of those. 20,000. We want to get that as much as possible. So chance is 59%. Can you show me this little pop-up? That'll be nice. Well, if you can read that, good luck. And then a research grant. We're going to go for scientific study. 50,000. Yeah. So this should go up. I'm not quite sure. It says something about buildings, staff. I can't read it. Anyway, we've added all of this on, which is good. So that's going to cost us a ton of money. And the varsity sports, the Teaport Chirpers. Oh, that is fantastic. I absolutely love that. We could change it. You could have the Alligators, the Broncos, the Buccaneers, the Chirpers, the Eagles. What should we go for? Oh, I know you guys and girls are fantastic with coming up with names. I'm going to leave it on the Teaport Chirpers at the moment. But yeah, you let me know what you think. So what have we got here? Advertising, cheerleader budget. Ping. Let's do that one. And also more coaches and staff. Yeah, we're going to do that one. Ticket prices. We're going to put that up because it seems like you put the ticket price up on everything else. It always helps. So 1-1 already. Oh, we've missed our first game. So I think with the amount of money that we're spending, that it's not going to take long before this can at least go up to one more level. So do you know what? It's nearly lunchtime. So I'm going to nip off. I'm going to have a little bit of lunch. I'm going to leave this running and see, jumpy game, see if we can get up to the next level. How about that? Okay, just a little update. We're coming up towards the end of the first academic year. Attractiveness is fine. Students, we've got, it's approaching up to 800 now, which is great. So when the year ends, then we will hopefully get some academic works. If we get a few more than we need, I think they roll over to the next year, which could help us with the next level. So we're going to just let this run and see what happens. Here we go. Any second now. It's going to roll over to the new year. What have we got? Oh, I'm so excited. Yay. Academic works one. One? What? I spent all that money and that's all we got. Okay. Extra students, extra everything else. But we got to the next level by the look of it. We already had these things. I'm a bit confused. But we have the School of Law. And grid or no grid? Oh, now that is a question. And we have two toga parties. That is absolutely fantastic. So we're not at the next level. But we've unlocked the School of Law. Did we have that already? And I completely missed it. Gotta be honest, I am slightly confused. Doesn't take much. If we scroll right to the end, School of Law. I bet we already had that. What other ones have we got? School of Science. Increase ambulance count and patient capacity. And this one, police department upkeep is reduced. I'm sure there's some sort of bonus to this one. Income from all specialized industries is increased. Oh, okay. Reducing pollution. And so these other ones are quite cool as well. We need to be prestigious to get those. But this School of Law, oh my giddy aunt. That building is humongous. That building is humongous. Can we fit this in here if we just mess around with some stuff? I think we could. There we go. I don't think that's too bad. Nestled in there. I quite like the fact that the tram runs around the top there. That's fantastic. So that's going to add another whole load of students as well, isn't it? Yeah. So we've got university students in the city, 3,600. Let's just take a quick look at this screen up here. If we open this one up on university. So eligible 14,699. Capacity 650. So what we're finding is there's plenty eligible in this area. I don't think we need to shut this one down up here as well. So I'm going to open that for now, but we do know that we can add other buildings in other parts of the city and have it part of the same campus. So for instance, we can see this zone here. If we grab this university zone, we could like run that up over here and add like a building at the top here somewhere. There we go. Just as an idea over here, and that will be part of the same campus. So maybe that is something that we could work on.